Well, I'm building my first ever robotic arm. It's fully 3D printed. A big thanks to JLCMC for sponsoring this video. More about them later. This robotic arm is completely 3D printed. Every single part you see here was made on my own 3D printer. And these are the parts I will be using. The STL files are linked in the video description, so you can build your own if you want. For the electronics, I'm using Arduino Uno and 3 WP5335 servo, 2 MG966 servos, 2 MG90 servos, a servo controller. First off, the core deck base. I have already inserted M4 nuts into the base so that it will be easier to connect it with other parts. And here in the base, the Arduino Uno and the servo controller will be mounted. And for fastening, I'm using an Allen nut and bolt kit that I got from JLCMC, your one-stop solution for all mechanical parts. They offer a huge range of mechanical components with industry-grade quality at a very affordable price as compared to others with super fast delivery. For example, you can get an aluminum enclosure for just $0.5, as well as other parts like shafts, gears, and bearings at amazing price. Ordering is super simple. Just search for the product, select the quantity, place the order, and you will get it delivered within 1 to 2 weeks. If you join through my link, then you will get a $70 coupon. And I got this parcel within 1 week, so let's unbox it. And as you can see, I have ordered a lot of things like these big bolts and Allen key nut and bolt kit, along with different screws, bolts, and nuts, and also these bearings and some brass spacers. And the quality of these products are just amazing, so you can check out JLCMC, link in the video description. Back to robotic arm, using M3 screws, I will attach the Arduino and the servo controller to the base. Next, I will mount a WP5335 servo to the core deck. I will place the servo into its slot. Then on the top of it, I will attach the 3D printed servo cap using M3 bolts. Once that's done, we will move to spin axis, again using a WP5335 servo and servo cover. I will place the servo into the slot, fasten it with M3 screws, and then attach the servo cap. Now it's time to connect the spin axis with the core deck. You can also use some super glue for extra strength. And for the lift arm, as you can see, I have already inserted M3 nuts into it. Before attaching the lift arm cover, we have to place another WP5335 servo. So I will place the servo into its slot and secure it using M3 bolts. And for a flex arm, we need a MG90 servo, so simply I will add the MG90 servo into it. And using a servo cap, we can connect flex arm with lift arm. So first of all, I will add the servo cap into the lift arm using an M3 bolt. Then we can connect flex arm and the lift arm together. And we can also add some super glue for extra strength. And for the Rotax joint, I will mount an MG9 6 servo, simply slide it into the slot and secure it with bolts. And in the twist core, I will add an MG90 servo into it and attach it into the slot. And after that, I will secure the MG9 6 servo and holder with M3 screws. Then we can join the twist core and the Rotax joint together. Once the mechanical parts are done, we can move to the wiring, and as you can see, here is the wiring diagram. According to that, we have to do all the wiring. So after completing all the wiring, I will secure the lift arm cover with 3 M3 bolts. Once that completed, it's finally look like an actual robotic arm skeleton. And now using some M4 bolts, we can mount our base into code deck. On top of that, we can attach the spin axis, then the lift arm, then the Rotax joint and flex arm and twist core. And the video is already getting little long. This is just part 1, we have got the frame and the wiring ready. In part 2, I will fully assemble it and show you the robotic arm in action, so stay tuned and don't forget to check out JLC MC, link in the video description.